On the 11th of April, the Clark South Member of Parliament, Gilbert Olanya, was brutally arrested after an altercation with security officers over a charcoal truck that had been offloaded days after both President Museveni and the State Minister of Environment, Beatrice Anyal, had banned burning of charcoal in the area. In the video that made rounds on social media, police were seen manhandling the legislator. Today, the Parliamentary Committee of Human Rights, chaired by the West Budama MP, Fox Odoi, interfaced with police bosses and grilled them on high-handedness that was applied in the arrest of the outspoken lawmaker.
How did they choose to arrest Honorable Olanya and fail to apprehend a truckload of charcoal? And have a file ready for Honorable Olanya? And there is no file at all for charcoal traders against all odds. Honorable Chair, let me repeat here from the notice of NEMA. All these people, individuals, deserve to pay $2 billion for the crimes they are committing.
Major General Geoffrey Tumsime Kasigazi told the committee that Honorable Olanya incited the community to wage mob justice on the truck that was ferrying charcoal, and police had to come in to save the situation. He added that the arrest was also in the best interest of the MP, as the mob had started stoning him.
The issue we had with the Honorable here was the incitement and causing mob action against the occupants of the lorry. And these are human beings like anybody else who could not watch as police when people are being molested or eventually losing their lives.
However, the committee was concerned that police had done less to protect the environment from degraders and instead resorted to arresting vigilantes who had offered to protect the community from ruthless charcoal burners.
Respect of the Honorable Olanya, but what are you doing to stem that environmental degradation? I don't want to put you in a situation where you prejudice your ongoing investigation.
Those who had loaded 200 bags of charcoal, did you find merit at all in arresting both those who were rowdy and those who are breaking environmental laws?
GP and the team, my issue is regarding the environmental police. I think this is the right time you should establish this department and let it be operational as soon as possible.
Police chiefs were also questioned on the recent ugly incident where police officers pepper sprayed journalists who were covering a protest of medical interns in Mulago. The deputy IGP regretted the incident, saying that officers involved were suspended.
We had agreed on some modus operandi last year, during the course of last year. So what happened? Why did you fail to implement our agreement to protect these journalists?
This matter was brought to our attention, and these individual officers have been suspended and referred a pending investigation for future action, for whatever the decision the investigating group will find out. But we were not happy, definitely. It soils our relationship with the general, and of course it's not professional.
Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.